So I'm Ellyn Leighton-Herrmann. I am with the Neurological Institute at Columbia University Medical Center. I am the lead research coordinator for Dr. Williams' lab. Our main focus is stroke, and we take a social science approach to stroke. We educate the entire spectrum of generations. We target children, we target their parents, and we target older adults to try to address the issue of timely arrival to the hospital for stroke. In addition to that, we also want to teach them about how to prevent stroke, because if we can prevent it and lower the incidence, that would really be the end goal for what we're trying to do. I am originally from Baltimore, Maryland. Then I am also from North Carolina as well as Virginia. My mother is an accountant, so she is a numbers person. My father is more creative. He does architecture and sales and business. So I'm much more like my mother on that side of things. I was actually encouraged to go into accounting, but I needed more than that. I love knowledge and gaining more of it. And through the research process, while you're improving the lives of others, you're also learning yourself. And I think that that's another one of the exciting parts, is that while it's knowledge gained for your participants, I'm gaining knowledge too. A lot of people don't even know the signs and symptoms of stroke. They don't know where a stroke occurs. The current treatment for a stroke, TPA, there is a time window of about 3 to 4.5 hours to get that treatment. And if people don't arrive in time, then their risk and disability after the stroke increases. So the goal is to get people to call 911 in a timely manner. I mean, the best case scenario is that it's not just that people arrive to the hospital in time for stroke, but it's to decrease the overall incidence of stroke. So while we are targeting the signs and symptoms and the need to call 911, we're also addressing the preventive component, the importance of diet and exercise, so that if we can limit the overall incidence of stroke, best case scenario, but in the event that there is a stroke, people know to call 911 as soon as possible. The research that we do is very much a team effort. Everyone brings a little something different to the table, and it's the combination of those skills and experience that really allow us to do what we do. We have the researchers who are best working with the participants. They really allow them to feel comfortable with what they're doing, which allows us to engage them in the research process. We have the researchers who are really good at writing the grants and doing the administrative side of research. So it's very much a team effort.
So we have our hip-hop stroke program that we've been delivering to students in an assembly-style setting for the past few years, and we are now taking that program and we are adapting it to a computer-mediated style. We had our research team do voiceover narration of the slides. We have the built-in question and answer sessions to help give them feedback so that they understand that they're actually learning the information. They can unlock characters and unlock music videos to really help and make an engaging process, even though it's being delivered through the computer.
Doing a stroke. Kids, come join me and let's do a stroke. Come on. Stroke, stroke. Put your hands down. Stroke, stroke.
And then the hopes that they share that information with their parents. You know, people might see a headache and think, oh, it's no big deal, they'll sleep it off, when it could actually be something much more serious. Teaching children can help save lives. We've had multiple children who have attended our program call 911 for a stroke, or they've encouraged an adult to call 911 for stroke. Our second project targets African American and Hispanic churchgoers. We recruit within the church setting and have developed two entertainment DVDs that teaches about the signs and symptoms of stroke and the importance of calling 911.
So this is the Spanish DVD that we developed. It is in the style of a telenovela.
Yeah.
And then this is the English DVD. We actually have two different films on here. The first one film was actually the Gospel of Stroke. And then as a supplement study that we're doing, we filmed The Stroke of Luck, which is a women's focused film looking at signs and symptoms as well as responses that are specific to women.
The church members who are participating in the program are really excited about the film. They enjoy coming back for their follow-up interviews And when asked, you know, about the film, some have actually shared it with others in their household. They've shared it with friends because they enjoyed it so much. They understand the importance of it. And so they're trying to get the word out as much as we are. I love it because it helps people. You know, being able to see the results of your work is what motivates me to keep doing it every day. It's not just going in and doing the research and then not seeing the results. It's seeing that people are really enjoying the interventions that we're implementing. And not only are they enjoying it, but they're learning from it. And then being able to apply the knowledge that they're learning. And you enter the data and you analyze the data and you have that hard proof that what you're doing is making a difference. It's hard work, but it's very engaging work. And by seeing the results, it will motivate you to keep wanting to do it, making a difference. Whether it be in stroke or cancer, any sort of health-related research, regardless of the area that a researcher is targeting, it's all important. It all has an impact. So it's important for people to engage in the process and engage others in the process. And while it might be difficult at times, you know, there will be results and lives will be saved and improved in the process.